everyone, my name is Aysel. Welcome to a new vectornator tutorial. Today's episode is all about autotrace. With our latest release, we have introduced a brand new autotrace mode, illustration. So I will be using Hokusai's great wave painting to illustrate all these modes and how they compare with each other. It's as easy as adding the image to the canvas. Go to autotrace from quick actions. You can see that illustration mode is already selected up top. It's the first one on the list, and I usually like to increase the minimum pad size, but I'm okay with the level of detail being regular. This is the result. As the name suggests, it has an illustration effect to it, with very crisp lines and not that many pads. And if we switch to photography mode instead, complexity 100%, we achieve this watercolor effect. And if we go to sketch mode with ignore white turned on, this is the result we get. Looks like a sketch, doesn't it? And the best part is that it's a vector. This is actually one single element, which makes it super easy to work with. So let's select the layer that contains it and look how easy it is to change the color. Now let's add a background because you will understand even better the ignore white function. So let's create a new layer, place it underneath, draw a simple rectangle, and then give it a cool gradient. Now you can really see that everything apart from black outline is actually negative space. It's not a white vector object. For this composition though, I actually prefer filling in my negative space. So I'm making a new layer under the wave. And then tracing the wave shape using the pen tool with fill on. The bottom here doesn't have to be perfect. It won't show anyway. I really love the way it looks, so I'm just going to stop here. Experiment with all our auto trace modes and let us know below which is your favorite. Like and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!